We heard what TN Seshan's opinion was when he spoke to our editor-in-chief, Arnab Goswami. We also caught up with the former law minister and currently Rajya Sabha MP, Ram Jethmalani. Let's listen to his views.
At a time when all the attention is on the parliament and what next steps will happen there in the Jan Lokpal Bill, we speak to BJP leader Mr. Ram Jethmalani. Sir, at this point of time, what are the options before the government? If a motion is passed by the BJP under 168, can the government go ahead? What options are there?
First of all, please understand that I am a very small member of the BJP. I am not by any chance a leader, and don't offend other leaders who are real leaders of the party. I think that the government is not acting wisely or honestly. There's a difference on the text of the Lokpal Bill, mainly centering around whether the Lokpal has jurisdiction over Supreme Court judges and whether the whistleblowers are being properly treated. These are really the two major issues. Now, today, has anybody any doubt, including a sitting Chief Justice like Mr. Barucha, who said that 20% of the higher judiciary is corrupt? So why should they not be subject to the jurisdiction of the Lokpal? Why? What? They want corrupt judges, and they want corrupt judges not to be subject to the Lokpal's jurisdiction. So this government is unnecessarily creating tension. Ultimately, it will bring about their downfall. I think they have lost their common sense.
So do you think the judiciary should be under the Lokpal?
Of course it should be. I have no doubt that it should be. And on the contrary, the Lokpal which we will have will be a Lokpal of the highest stature. That's very good for the institution of the Lokpal. But he will also be a person who is qualified to sit in judgment over Supreme Court judges.
Sir, if the BJP does move this rule under 168 to have the discussion with voting, what options are there before the Speaker? Can the Speaker refuse such a motion?
I think that the Speaker has really no power. The main thing has to be decided by the advisory committee. And in a democracy, why should there not be a discussion which should result in a vote? How do you ascertain who has the majority on every issue? Otherwise, what is the use of this discussion? Discussion is going on at Ramlila ground.
So lastly, Rahul Gandhi goes ahead today and says that in the longer stream of things, one act, one Jan Lokpal Bill will not wipe out corruption. How do we view this?
Well, I'm glad to say that Rahul has some idea of the magnitude of corruption, and he should be treated as an expert witness in this, and he's absolutely right there.
Sir, in this regard, do you believe the Jan Lokpal Bill will have any sort of a corruption standoff? Will it be stopping corruption? Because according to the Congress, it's not in the long run.
I'll tell you that it is a very, very important and significant step which will put the fear of God at least into some people who are today indulging rampantly in corruption. But it is not the be-all and end-all of the fight against corruption. The fight against corruption still remains and will have to be carried on with greater vigor than the fight over the Lokpal Bill.